He's not even in the box anymore, sleeping. He's never done that before. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. This is the last video that you are going to see in this outfit and makeup, and I'm just really behind. I'm sorry, but I hope you guys really don't mind. This is my empty Sandy clutters for January of 2020, the first one this year. And I have not added anything from February into this empty spin. So this is strictly what I used up in January. My beauty trash, just saying. I have a few declutters, as I said, and I will go through those first. And then we can talk more about the empties afterwards. I put this product into my Finish 20 in 2020. And when I wanted to use it just after I filmed and uploaded that video, I realized it was completely dry. And I did look at it and it didn't seem that dry. It is so dry. Like, can you see it is even cracking? It is so dried up. And yeah, I don't know if I'm going to buy this again. Maybe I am. Right now I'm using one from the Body Shop and I really, really like that one. I have only tried it once, but I do like that better than this one. The Pure & Care Volcanic Charcoal Mask. It is cheaper, so that might be the reason why I would buy this again over the Body Shop one. But let's see how I like the Body Shop one better, maybe, than this one. This is a declutter though, because it is not usable at all. I'm sad. I really wanted to have it to be counted in my empties, but I need to be real with myself and I did not use this up. It dried out. This makes me sad. So, so, so sad. This is the color 2 from Maybelline in Metallic Pomegranate. I am so sad because this is such a beautiful shade and it's not completely dry. It does transfer a little bit of product, but oh my god. Do you see how it is pulling from the edge right there? It is the same as the Permanent Taupe color 2 that I had. I really, really, really wanted to use this up. And I just started a few days before I started my projects and into 2020. So that is why it is in January. And it was right before I did my inventory. So it's not even in my inventory. This is straight up glitter on my eyes. There's no beautiful pomegranate cranberry shade on my eyes. Nothing. I'm so sad. It is so beautiful. And I would have loved, loved to use this up. But it was just not meant to be. So this is decluttered. That is just what happens when you have too much stuff. I keep my makeup empties in this small cute bag. But I only have 3 this time around. They are exciting though. The least exciting is the Body Shop Shade Adjusting Drops in Lightning. The lighter shades. Well, this is a lifesaver if your pill is paper like me and everything is too dark. This is amazing. I have gone through quite a few of these. I will take a break from it though, and I have had this for so long, much longer than I will admit. When I used it up, I realized this was the thing that caused me to break out a lot on my chin. And I said that in my inventory as well. But yeah, it is done now. I can't get anything out. Now it is something else that is breaking me out. I need to figure out what. I don't know what that is, because that means I can eliminate a category from my makeup inventory. I'm excited about that. The next one is my Diary 7 Face Fantasy Matte Finish Foundation in Sand. This is a beautiful foundation. It is the second bottle that I have used up of this. I've used up the lighter shade and then this shade, and I have bought the lighter shade again to mix with this to use it up. Sounds stupid, but it was a third of the price as the Body Shop Lightning Drops, so I thought it was appropriate to just use the same formula to lighten a foundation that was too dark. I had this in my This Is Me project pan and I was very excited when I use this up. And yes, I scrape everything out of my products. Something is on here on the side, on the front, but I'm not going to do anything about that. It is done. I'm really excited about this one. The last color too in my stash, it is the Creme de Nude from Maybelline. This is done. I'm so excited. This is done. Oh my god, I have not used this in a while, and it is still so weird to just use a regular eye primer than this, because I did use this as my primer. It did not work just as good as an ordinary eye primer, because my lids are oily. They are. So this was not the best, but it did work for what it should. So yeah, it's done. Very excited about that. So that is a better story than the one that I am going to declutter. But that also means I don't have any more color to use in my collection. I have more cream shadows though, and they are drying up as well. So I'm going to be on a mission this year to use those up. 3 items left. It is going to be a quick one. Oh well. 8 minutes in and I'm rambling. I have used up another one of the Pure & Care Witch Hazel Serums. I love this stuff so much, and I do use it every single day, every single night and morning, and I have even gotten John to use this every single night. I just need to get him used to do something in the morning as well. It works wonders for skin that tends to break out a lot, and both mine and John's skin are doing that. So this is amazing. Witch Hazel is a lifesaver if you have skin that breaks out. Let's take this one and end on a sad note. Why not? This is a perfume sample from Chloe, and I think it's just her regular perfume. It's really, really nice, and it was a single use thing. I used this up and I'm pretty excited about it, because then I don't have to watch this again anymore in my stash. The last item I have is my Batiste Instant Hair Refresh Dry Shampoo for dark hair, Divine Dark. I'm going to eat my words that I said last time I used one of these up. Logical Harmony says on her page, this is not cruelty free. Until a few weeks ago, it said on the Batiste cans, they were cruelty free and vegan, as this one says. There you go, vegan, not tested on animals. Which, in my mind, means they're cruelty-free, right? A few weeks ago, I saw that the packaging has changed. And I was curious if it said still on the cans that they're cruelty-free. It doesn't. So, they are testing on animals. Oh my god, I am so sad, because this is my last bottle, last can, and I can't buy it again because I'm trying to go cruelty free, and I have not found any dry shampoo that works, except this one. I'm on a budget. I'm trying not to buy any expensive stuff, because I really want to save my money, and I'm on a replacement no buy for 2020. Let me know if you want an official video on that. I'm doing something on Instagram where you insert if you have bought something that day. But yes, that means I cannot buy this again, and I'm testing out another one, and I don't like it, because I like this one much better, and it dry shampoo is my life, folks. It is my life, because my roots are oily, and this is the only thing that does that I don't have to shower every single day. And so showering every single day for your hair is not good at anyway. It's not good. I don't know what to do. Let me know if you have some budget-friendly dry shampoos that is cruelty-free, and if it is on this status, please let me know. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. There was not that many products, but I have been here forever apparently, and I'm just in the mood to ramble, which I don't understand, because it's late and I need to go to bed now. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know if you want any no buy videos or something like that, I can share what I bought in January, which was not a lot. But yeah, I'm trying to save up some money and not buy as much stuff. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and like it if you did. Subscribe down below if you're new here. I would love for you to hang around. I do a lot of prep pants, empties and stuff like that. I hope you guys are going to enjoy that content. And yeah, until my next video, please take care. Bye.